Hey guys, welcome back to the Wild Dog Project 365, episode 1572. Guys, you're following along on YouTube, jump on over to thewilddog.com. Check out all the full-length videos that we house there. What we're talking about today is an overlooked movement that is great for sagittal strength, improve our back squat, improve our deadlift, and that is the good morning, the standing good morning. I'm gonna show you with an empty barbell the key factors that I like to see people do. Now, when we're talking about the good morning, we're talking about improving low back and high hamstring strength, okay? So if we think about this, this is a movement where our butt is gonna come back and our chest is gonna come forward. We're gonna get into a position that allows us to gather as much hamstring tension as we can, and then we're gonna drive on back forward. This is a horizontal hip motion, okay? And we don't have any vertical translation. So if you were to take your hand, put it on your hip, if we push our butt back and I start to feel hamstring length getting taken up, that slack that's getting taken up, and I continue to bend forward until I really gather all that slack up, from right there, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna drive my hips forward until I can finish that movement and feel that top of that hamstring and the bottom of that back contract here. The only difference that we're gonna do that between what I just showed you and the actual good morning is we're gonna do this in a back squat or a back rack position. So I'm gonna take that same position here. I'm gonna step on under and I get myself in this weight, okay? In this weighted position, this back squat position. I'm gonna take a hip width stance, so my feet are gonna be underneath my hips from right here. I'm gonna drive my hips back as my chest comes forward. Big things that we wanna pay attention to here is, am I hitting hamstring length? So for right here, am I hitting hamstring tension length? So from right here, do I feel that pull into my hamstring? Am I allowed to, or am I able to keep that back straight without overarching or without allowing myself to bend or fold through my back? If I am, that's gonna be a good rep. So this is a hinge movement only. I'm gonna feel some tension build into the hamstrings, push that butt back continually until I feel that hamstring length gather all of it, all that tension. I'm gonna allow myself to get into that position, maybe a little athletic bend in my knee, drive my hips forward. I'm gonna move myself forward just so you guys can see that. So I start with my hips completely locked out. I drive my butt back as my chest comes forward. I really feel that hamstring length gather, that tension gather. I almost feel a burn in the back of my thighs. Allow a little tiny bend in those hamstrings or in those knees to get that athletic bend. Drive those hips forward. And just to give you guys a little bit of a reference point, we should be able to do somewhere around 5 reps of our 80% back squat. And that's a lot for a lot of people, and we're nowhere close to that for a lot of us. So if we're looking to build strength out of the hole, build strength with our deadlifts, this is a great way to do that. Questions, comments, guys, posted below. Otherwise, we are here each and every day, optimizing function to optimize performance.